All right, I'm back. Son of Light here again, smoking on some good weirwood weed, drinking that Dornish wine. So now here's my video that I've had to make four times, which is okay. I really don't mind. But now here's what I gotta say about Daenerys. Do I want to see her on the Iron Throne? First of all, someone, taking a sip really quick. First, someone said in my Golden Company's video, is the Golden Company worth their salt, that I'm a Daenerys fanboy? Now, I'm not hating on the guy. Thank you for your comment. Respect you as a fan, or whichever you are. Hater, fan, person that just stopped by. I really don't. My respect diminished for Daenerys when she let Yara become an ally without her bending the knee. All she had to get was raping, looting, and pillaging. But when Jon Snow came along, you better bend that knee, boy. Because if not, you're my enemy in the north. First of all, Daenerys... You killed Jon Snow's grandfather. You killed Jon Snow's uncle. Right? And you want him to bend the knee? Remember, Jon Snow's family, aka our father, unquote, unquote, Ned Stark, protected him as a Targaryen. So that already proves that Ned Stark's family, which I know he will claim them, even though he says even though he is a Targaryen, he will still be, because he is part of Stark, because Lyanna Stark, but he still will claim the Starks as his family. Ned Stark still protected a Targaryen child. So that proves how far his family, or at least the family members of him, were going, how far they were going just to protect a Targaryen. So honestly, Ned's act diminished the whole thing against his wrongdoings, even though Ned and his whole family really had no wrongdoings. The Mad King was killing people, burning people, etc. And the second thing is, Jon Snow doesn't owe you an apology. Anyway, that wasn't it. The second thing actually is Daenerys doesn't belong on the Iron Throne to me is because she is not humble enough. While the Night King might have killed one of her dragons, if it doesn't make her humble herself in Season 8, I really do not want to see her on the throne because she's a hypocrite between the way she treated Yara and the way she treated Jon Snow. While I know Jon Snow could, his family could have something behind that and the way she acted, still, no. I don't agree she'd be on the Iron Throne. Plus, she kind of had that whole dragon rage thing where she's like, all my dragons are better and, you know, I don't really have to bow down to anyone. Which she really didn't because she did have the dragons, but she made the dragons skew her point of saving Westeros. Like in season 1, 2, 3, and 4, where she was like in Gung Kai and all those other places and helping with the slavers and all that. That is the Daenerys I liked, and that's who I wanted to see on the Iron Throne. And plus, the way she didn't believe Jon about the dead. Now here's a plot hole, in my honest opinion, which I don't like. And George R. R. Martin, right here, right now, if you ever see this video, and I know you won't, please, please, please keep Tyrion on the same level in the books, other than D&D, who is messing with the show, and I'm about to show you right now.
I've lost count.
Lord Commander asks that we send more men to man the wall.
Perhaps he's forgotten we're fighting a war. We have no men to spare.
The cold winds are rising, and the dead rise with them.
The Northerners are a superstitious people.
According to the Commander, one of these dead men attacked him in his chambers. Mormont doesn't lie.
That was then. This is now.
The dead are the enemy.
The dead? Is that another figure of speech?
The army of the dead is on the march.
The army of the dead.
You don't know me well, my lord, but do you think I'm a liar or a madman?
No, I don't think you're either of those things.
So George R. R. Martin, please, if you ever see this video, keep Tyrion on the same track in the books, because this is just terrible writing. At first, Mormont doesn't lie, and I believe in the dead. Jon Snow mentions the dead, and I don't believe him when I've been just surrounded by dragons, and I'm dissing Daenerys now. You got dragons, the undead house, and that other stupid warlock girl that nearly attacked you, which happens more in the books, actually, but you don't believe in the dead? Okay, then. And Tyrion, you believe when Mormont said it, but you don't believe when Jon Snow says it? If I've seen two reoccurring, I know it's a long time ago, but Tyrion is a smart man. At least he was in the show. If I were to see two recurring, you know, factors of the dead being mentioned, I'd be like, okay, this is now solid proof, and I believe in him. I would have believed him when Jorah Mormont sent that thing, that letter. So you know what? No, I don't want Daenerys on the Iron Throne. You know who I want on the Iron Throne? Let me show you. And he wished on a dragon scale, and that's what started dragon tales. Around the room the dragons flew, but Emmy and Max knew what to do. They climbed on the backs of the dragon friends. Now the adventures never end. Dragon. That's damn right. I want Max and Emmy Targaryen on the Iron Throne. Look at that. You seen how they flew dragons without any help? And they were children. And you see that two-headed dragon combined together, green and purple? Daenerys, you're not even no match. Anyway, but seriously though, who I really want on the Iron Throne would be Jon Snow. Because he's a man of the people, he knows how to talk to them, he probably would believe anything, and would work together to help the greater good, while like if the dead is ever mentioned again, it could be taken serious, but like let's say something silly is mentioned, like let's say if I hit the mic, sorry, let's say if, you know, something silly in Game of Thrones, I don't know, let's say like they don't believe Catelyn Stark is alive, then he sends men out there to go check it out, but when they come back and confirm, hey, you know, she's alive and she's killing everyone, okay, Jon Snow will believe it now and he will send more people out there to help because it's proven. But yeah, I do not want Daenerys on the throne, so that's just my opinion. So leave a comment, guys. Comment, like, subscribe, dislike, whichever. Let me know, who do you want on the Iron Throne? See you guys around.